Suhasi and Karan, first of all, a warm welcome to GlitzVision USA.
Hi.
Hi, thank you.
Okay, we were interviewed separately, but we were getting a lot of requests to interview together. Okay, so let's start the interview. The first question which every fan and even as a media house, we want to ask, so starting with Karan.
Because it's something very different, doesn't happen every day, and the fact that we can go and question the society on this aspect about falling in love with someone elder, especially women who are elder than men, or women who are elder than boys. So, but apart from that, yeah, the idea was basically anything that has a social message to it, or something attached to the fact that you can question the society and change opinions and perceptions is what made me do this.
Yeah, the fact that, of course, as he said, that it's a kind of a different story. It's not a very, very out of the box thing, but these kind of shows have happened before, but very rarely. So, the beautiful part of the story is you get to do some scenes or some feelings that you usually don't get to do in normal love stories, daily soap. What happens is mostly it's a normal love story with an older boy or the younger women, and otherwise it's more of a saas bahu thing. This is not any of those. So you get different shades and different you know, colors, different kind of things to play as a character. I was very happy. I had given look tests with a lot of people, lot of boys, young boys, and somehow I felt that, you know, I don't know, we're not getting the right kind of person, the right kind of boy for this character. And then we were just discussing with the creative and all, and then he came up. And it was just a casual thing, just called me, ki, achha, there's one another guy. And for me, it was like, okay, aur ek ladka. And then he did it, and me and the director, we both were there. And then we just shared a look and we're like, huh, I think. So I was very happy. I was very happy.
I was totally chill about it. I mean, I remember going for my audition on that particular day, and then I met her over there. And I was asking my director, I'm like, who is this chick? I mean, who is this girl who I'm going to shoot the entire show with and all? He's like, yeah, yeah, she's been working since a while. I'm like, okay. So I met her, and it was just very casual, very chill. And because the character was somewhere that, so nowhere did I want to put across a particular mindset, listen, okay, I'm working with someone senior, or I'm working with someone junior, or I'm working with someone who I've never worked with. So it was very chill, very, very, very normal, and I'm so glad that I'm here. I'm a very careless person, so somewhere I think she has a problem with that. I don't take care of myself sometimes, so she sometimes gives me like fruitful gyan about taking care of myself and all, which is very genuine and which is very very warm, because it's good to know that people around you take care of you, like from my creative director to my director to the production house to her, the prime people who I'm working with on the show. So that's very important. And apart from that, I think the impression was that I'm not a judgmental person, so I've never really developed a particular impression about somebody. And I'm totally full of gratitude and acceptance about whoever they are as a person. But the vibe was great. It's all about the vibe and the energy, which was very great. And here we are. It's been a few months and we've been doing a good job.
No, I was always expecting this kind of what he is because of his what age he is at right now. And the fact that, as he said, the positive vibe is what really makes a lot of difference on the set. When we all sit together, and whenever somebody comes from outside also, they always say that there's always a positive vibe on the set. So of course, positive vibe comes from all of us, right? So yeah. Yeah, so yeah.
Who has learned? Anybody has learned?
Yeah, I think you should ask this question later so that we get some time to think.
But has some answer?
Well, I think what I've learned is some thairav, because that's something I never had.
You learned from Vedika.
Yeah, Vedika only, of course. Person who's playing Vedika, because you're acting Vedika. So that definitely comes with some experience, and she's got that on the platter over here, which is quite helpful, because somewhere I know that my problem has always been talking fast or getting done with my lines and all of that. So somewhere I know where to give a pause and all of that. And it's only when you notice somebody, you understand, okay, this is where sometimes, you know, you should also modulate scenes and all of that. Kuch zyada hi bol diya kya?
Haan, bahut zyada. I have learned one thing. Never share. Never put a chocolate in front of him. He always eats it. He khatam kar di tune.
On the pot.
He has a lot of energy and he comes on the set. What happens is some actors, they come on the set, they read the scene and they come on the set directly. Depending on the director, you know, that whatever that he says, we'll be doing, because this is how TV works. He comes with a thought and what happens is then sometimes we sit together and we have a discussion about what he comes with a thought and he wants to do that, which is very rare. He's already formed, he has a kind of a paper in his room where he's written all about the character and what happens with the character, how the character has to be. So that thing is always there in his mind that, you know, Sahil is this. Sahil, so that thing never goes out of his mind, which is very good. You know, to every now and then, you know, you need to just hit the head with saying that, achha, Sahil aisa nahin karega. Sahil aisa karega. That's a very good quality.
I think that one quality that she comes in with is with a lot of confidence, because sometimes I am very unsure about how my scene will go. Like, for example, I have a flowchart in my mind before I come for a scene. And until I do it, I don't know whether I'll be able to perform it. So I don't know what will I do. That is my, that's my pro and my con as well. At the same time, I know what exactly she's going to do and deliver at a particular point of time. Because definitely there's a contrast in the character. And but that confidence is something that I really want as well. So somewhere down the line, I hope to get it.
Okay, in the last interview, Suhasi also mentioned that you are the only that.
Can I see this interview again, please?
Why?
I make her feel older. Yeah, what am I supposed to do? I see, it's the two things, firstly, alright? So, firstly, I keep myself very confined to my room and all of that. I've never really gotten out and had like a big conversation or something with anyone. So, for me, everyone is an aap over here. Like, aap kya jaane se is like for is universally for everyone. So you can edit this actually. But apart from that. Yeah, but I can never call her Suhasi because I have some regard for her as a person and all, and considering that you have a family every
time. Bas ho gaya, ye edit hi kar do, ye question hi edit kar do, sab edit kar do.
Yeah, so Vedika ji is Vedika ji, but sometimes I tell some Vedika ko yahan ye baat kar raha hai. That's okay, you can.
Okay, last question.
It's okay. Actually it's a give and take over there, because in between a scene also, like yesterday, something just happened, and the thing is, the problem with us is that I don't know what happened, but the laughing doesn't stop sometimes. And you know, sir just gives 2 minutes, you have to laugh and all, and sometimes there are scenes where we have to look into each other's eyes and all continuously. And after that, so I've been told not to go close to her. That's why she goes a little cockeyed sometimes. So yeah, so we laugh on these little nuances.
Okay.
Yeah, he's, as he mentioned before, I am absolutely. He is very, he eats crap all the time, and he doesn't sleep. Well, of course, the energy doesn't go down, but somewhere down the line, it will start affecting. And he's not very careful about his body and his health. Okay. I think I'll stop here. Yeah. Okay. Too many complaints.
What is the question again? That she is totally the opposite of me. Is the most annoying thing. Like, dabba, wabba, everything and all. Come on, yeah, like, I know you're 42 and all, but you can behave 24 sometimes. Arey, matlab, as Vedika ji. So yeah, I mean, but the most annoying thing is like, I celebrate junk and crap. She should also sometimes do that, like sometimes at least. Like that day on set, she got like mawa cake and all, which was great and all. But that should happen like every day, become habitual and all. I could call it a very, I don't know if I can call it a particular adjective or describe it in a particular form, but it's been a very exhilarating journey till now. bundle of emotions have come out as my character as well. So I think I'm very grateful that I got an opportunity to work with her. And Abhi, I'm giving the mic to her to say that.
Suhasi, he has said some great words. It's your turn.
No, I'm serious.
Stupid.
Yeah.
He is full of energy during the scenes and off screen. He doesn't... No, I cannot express it in one word.
Just describe. Not one word, one line.
What happens is energy passes through, you know.
Yeah.
So when he comes on the set and when he does the scene that his character requires, how his character requires, then energy passes. Sometimes what happens is I also take that energy and I start flowing, which sometimes is wrong as well because my character doesn't require that.
That's
where he says, Suhasi. So yeah, that energy is great to have on the set.
Okay, so thank you so much for doing this segment. And any last message to the fans of Samil and Vedika? We really love your, you know, on-screen chemistry, the on-screen pairing. And don't give a good message.
Firstly, of course, I never call you my fans. You guys are friends and I make it a point to talk to you all whenever I can on social media or wherever possible. At the same time, thank you. It's a very different show. At the same time, you guys are giving us some love and some respect because honestly, I didn't really know what was going to happen once the show started. But looking at how it's going and with regards to families watching it at home, and we may not be a rave on social media, but at least we're doing very graceful work, which is very important, and we're creating a difference in the society. So thank you, and it means a lot. So I hope you guys keep continuing your support and your love, and we'll try to entertain you as far as we can as Sadika.
Yeah, I would like to say thanks because when I signed this show, I did not know how long this show is going to run, because sometimes what happens is we expect a lot out of the show, but the show wraps up in 3 months. So I was expecting ki chalo ye kuch nahi to 3 months chalega, let's see what happens. But the kind of love, the kind of response everybody has given, although the show is a late night show, is beautiful. I was not expecting that kind of a thing. Thanks so much for loving us, and we will try and show you better performances and better stories. So please keep on seeing the show. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks. Fall in love.